try it with water or without water.
He's doing some science right now.
And so we'll take this.
What's he gonna do?
Now, these particular launchers, these are things you can buy the components at Home Depot. If any of you are interested at your science teachers, I have a whole bunch of these I can send out to science teachers if other kids would get involved in doing it. So who wants to come up and try pumping the pumper? Okay, we need some kids. We need some kids to pump this up. Now, this is driven by air pressure. See how squishy this is? Who wants to try and pump it up? Okay, let's see who pumps it up. So air pressure is the same thing you put in your tires. All right, but as we pump it up, we try pump it. Okay, so now it's getting stiffer and stiffer, right? That's because the air pressure from the pump is going into this. Now, when you pump up your bicycle tires or your car tires, what's the pressure you pump it up to? It's like 30, right? Well, what do you think the units of that are? It's 30 pounds per square inch. So right now we're at 20 pounds per square inch. What that means is if you took a little square inch and pushed in, I'd have to push in 20 pounds before I'm deflect. So right now we're at 20. We're going to go up to maybe 60 or so. Again, there's some brochures of mine. I do this in classrooms. I do after school programs, in school programs. Okay, so now we're at 40 pounds pressure. And again, this is the first water rocket we've done today, so we don't quite know where the water is going to go.
It's a water rocket.
Okay, we're at 60. Now, some of the kids made these earlier. These are parachutes where we just took a bag that you get at the supermarket. We put some beans in three corners of it.
And
Camp Kaleidoscope, my kids invented this week at our camp. Before, I had them doing it out of strings with a big weight, and the strings would get all tangled, but one kid, Nico, came up with a new one, and that's what we're trying to do, is encourage invention. And it blows the doors off of any yellow parachutes we did. So this is our first water launch pressure. So again, it's just a plastic bag. It's got some beans or acorns or whatever you want into the corners. We're going to put this in. All right, who wants to pull the launch button?
Me!
Okay, who did the pumping? The rules are whoever does the pumping can do all the launch, but we might have to actually come over. You're going to pull the launch button. Wait, come over here. And you may have to lift him up. We're going to grab this handle and pull it down, but let's give him a countdown. All right? So you're going to see that handle, you're going to pull it down. Okay, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, look at that parachute. All right, that's a good parachute. All right. Okay, let's just bring the bottle back up. Now, if these are things that if any of your science teachers I could give you kits for, or if you send me an email, I can send how to build it from here. Okay, so if you want to help, you can try to pop it up. So you're going to put that over. It's a coolant mechanism. That if you look at Ask This Old House and Google Water Bottle Rockets, they have a whole program of how to do it. I've been doing this for 10 years, and I heard it there like that 2 weeks ago.
And it's
these things can go probably 300 feet up in the air and stuff. The other air tube rockets that we do later, those go almost out of sight. Those go a quarter of a mile high. Just with air pressure.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is going. Okay, so you start pumping up. Let's bring the other parachutes up. Wait. Let's do it with water, because the water made it a little more interesting, right? Okay, so we'll put some water in.